We are proud, Louise Angelbert and me, Greg Belair, to announce now the results of the second call for residencies. We had the pleasure to see how far the first wave of residency went from last September to up to now. Now we will see what's coming next. So the selection of the residencies is pretty expert process involving a lot of actors. First, the artist, of course, who make a quality application in relation to a tech project. The tech project are also involved in the reviewing of these applications, in the process of pre-selection. And then there is an international jury that is selecting the final residencies. So we will first present this second call jury. The meeting held at Ircam on the 24th and 25th of May 2018. In this jury, we had 12 people.
Should I?
Yes, please.
Okay, so just to present briefly the members of the jury. So we have Benoît Maujean. He's there, actually, so thank you.
Hi, Benoît.
Jérôme Verkamer, Greg Beller here, Chris Julian, Paul Dujardin, then Ligger Brummer, Laurence Leny.
We just arrived. Hi, Laurence.
Ah, yes, perfect. Perfectly on time. Sorry, so I was. I'm
Maud
just
Franca,
looking at the yeah
yes,
the picture.
Maud Franca,
Laurence Leny,
yes.
Irini Papadimitriou, Francesca Bria, Camilla Baker, and I think I forgot Martin Hanzik from Ars Electronica. So
great.
That was the jury. Thank you very much for being there for the selection of the great laureates that we're going to announce now.
So we had 2 days meeting, working hard all together to do this difficult task to select quality-based residencies. Quality based on what? On innovation, on quality of the artists, openness of the tech project, and we try each time to select promising matching, actually, which is for us the most important thing is to see all the aspects, the artists, the tech project, and also the production, the producer associated to the applications. So just before going to the announcement of the second waves of STARTS residencies, I just would like to say that our third call is already open, actually, to the tech projects. So if you are a tech project in Europe and you want to apply to the STARTS residency program, this is possible already. You can just visit the starts.eu website and present your project, be in the list where the artists will build applications. Then the 7th of September, the third call for artists will be open till November, and you will be able to make proposals according to these tech projects. And of course, also there is a third call, which is a call for producer that is also ongoing, where producer can manifest their interest into the program and support some of the residencies. Okay, so let's. It's enough talk. Let's announce right now the 17 laureates of the second call. Just when we will present the results, if some of the artists or the, of the tech projects or of the producers are in the room. We keep the audience light open, so please just stand up so as maybe you can directly meet with your partners today. Okay, so let's go. So the first selected residency is called Embryonic. The artist is Valeria Abendroth. Her art with sculptures, installations, and video art is reflected in themes about human being, traditions, and modernity, and have a social and societal meaning. She applied to the tech project called 3D Prime that helps medical students in their learning and study efforts with accurate 3D printed models of their patients. Together, they will work on the Embryonic project, which is a three-dimensional interactive room installation that represents a developmental laboratory, including biomorphing sculptures that seem to be alive and growing.
Then we have My Fears May Mute to You by Laurent Bazin. Maybe you can stand up.
Yes.
Okay, congratulations. So Laurent is going to be linked to the project that is called Virtual Close-Up. So Laurent is a performer artist. He created the company Mesden, through which he writes his own plays and perform. And so the Virtual Close-Up project really aims at working on the virtual environment and try to see how we can experience virtuality really close up. It's really the point of this project. And so for this, they are exploring light manipulation techniques, optical illusion, etc. And so the project that is proposed by Laurent Bazin, the company Mesden, is My First Memo to You. So the idea is really to demonstrate that when you have the good tools, you can shoot simple yet very overwhelming things and immersive filmmaking. And I see that you're like saying yes, so I might present this quite well. So great. So really, and so first using these tools, and then they would like to establish a tool and then a film methodology that could be used by the other professionals to really use those quite sometimes difficult tools to easily, let's say.
Congrats, we really look forward to the beginning of your residency. Then we have Data Union Fork, Tools for Data Strike Residency from Larissa Blazik. Congratulations. You are a media artist, educator, researcher, and a feminist hacker with over 20 years of internationally acclaimed practice ranging from net.art to floss art and design. The Decode project that is hosting you is an overall challenge, is giving citizens back full control of respecting personal data protection and fundamental rights framework. So Data Union Forks, Tools for Data Strike, is an idea building on this OS, the Decode OS, blockchain-based operating system, and nodes for decentralized ownership and control of data, to conceptualize, articulate, and to co-create an assertive smart contract model enabling additional protective lawyer for citizen digital rights, whilst promoting solidarity and mutual aid. Congratulations, Larissa.
So, Sleep in the City by Walid Brady and Virgil Novarina.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. So, Walid is a multidisciplinary digital arts. And Virgil is a visual artist and a performer, and he's dedicated to the exploration of the sleep, and he does this through writings and drawings. Harris City Lab is a project about smart city, how it is now and how it can be. So it really wanting to be the place for co-creating and engaging urban experiments. And with this project, those two artists want to create sleep in the city. So it's gonna be a performance that with videos projected all around the cities that really want to sensitize people about the importance of the sleep. And so while the performer will be sleeping, then we'll have a video projected in the city reflecting the sleep. So congratulations, and really looking forward to discover this.
It's such a huge mountain to climb, so we can applaud and congrats. Bio-inspired AI musical composition is the project of Alberto Carretero Aguado. Alberto studied composition and piano at the Higher Music Conservatory of Seville with extraordinary awards. He holds the degree of computer science engineer, musicology, journalism, master and PhD in music composition. AIO is a big data and AI-driven observatory and policy-making instruments on AI research and tech innovation. So the project is about music and composition using this technology. Alberto is interested in the compositional, the technical and expressive tools of this technology to develop the concepts of bio-inspired techniques of artificial intelligence in his music for acoustic, electroacoustic instruments and involve performers. Congratulations.
Let's go to Spelayan from Felix Scott and the collective talks.
Okay,
so you're all there. That's nice. So that's the collective. So it's made of four artists, as you can see here. It's pluridisciplinary artists that are bringing new stuff from their cooperation. Dean is a project on working on the conception of an active system that could be able to interact with a person in this like interaction man object. So how you can interact with object. And for this, they would like to create a new e-material system. And so the collective toast is going to use this new e-material that will, and they will present it and so offer the public to explore and interact with this ever-changing surface. So when you go underneath or when you're moving around, then the surface is moving. So I think it's quite a huge project and we're really looking forward to see what's gonna happen. So thank you for being there.
Good luck,
let's,
guys.
Let's discuss about this a bit later.
Fruit of the daydream. Julie Desmet Weaver, I think maybe Julie is still here.
Yeah.
I saw her today. Hi, Julie. Congratulations. So you've been involved in the exploration of writing, involving digital language in order to offer new experiences to the viewer and to initiate meetings around literary, visual, sound, and interactive stories. Le Cube, so I think people from Le Cube are here as well. Welcome. The challenge of the project is to prototype an immersive and interactive content for collective virtual reality. So Frost of the Daydream is an immersive and interactive and sensitive experience. The whole narrative space becomes a tangible multisensory interface. The viewer enters into the skin of Colin, crossed by his story, his joys, his desires, his fears. So we really look forward entering into the skin of Colin. Thank you.
So the next one is Atom Chasm from Dimitri Gelfin and Evelina Domnic. So it's a really interesting field of art. They are melting physics, chemistry, computer science with philosophical practices, and they are linked to the project Art Atom. Art Atom is the departure of the project. The fact is that we can't see a single trapped atom easily, and so the idea is that we can't see this if we're not entering a really modern research lab. So the idea is to develop an imaging system that can enable anyone to see this in a free space, and then the artists are going to create a laser-cooled atom observatory that will allow this phenomenon, and we will have then the first artwork to be ever presented on an atomic scale. So let's see this.
Thank you for being here. Both are here, so you can start to work, actually. Okay, ORS, Orbital River Station. A.A., Ellen Evans and Heiko Hansen are an artist duo based in Paris with humor. Their work questions the ever-present energy needs of contemporary life, visualizing social, industrial, and ecological paradoxes that result from today's technological landscapes. Nano to Water explores a portfolio of technologies which include biosensing devices and novel tailored nanomaterials for selective recognition and capture of water contaminants. So the project called Orbital River Station is both an environmental vehicle and an artistic performance space to sense and experience the ecological dynamics of rivers.
Maybe Bipolar is there.
Okay.
Yeah, the producer is here, so thank you for producing this.
It will be produced by Bipolar. Okay. Okay, transhuman expression. Lyatt Graver.
Here.
Congratulations. So since January 2016, you've been collaborating with the University of Constance on the eDavid project, exploring various approaches to integrate robotic and computer languages in the processes of painting and creative image making. We draw develops multisensory technology to learn math, combined with arts and improve creativeness of children. So transhuman expression is a human-machine interaction as a neutral base for a new artistic and creative practice. A series of visual imagery in the form of paintings, as well as digital and video-based materials, created by the interaction between human, computer, and robotics. Congratulations.
So, qui perd gagne, so in a way in English, who loses win, so by Pascal Martin Tailloux and Hybrid Games. So, Hybrid Games, I think we have the representative. No. They left before the ceremony. Nice. No, that's okay. Pascal, it's quite hard to define the work of Pascal. Because he is not really confining himself to one artistic medium or to one particular set of issues. So it's quite a large way of expressing and performing arts. And he is has a postulate that is always use himself as a person as a point of departure for his work. He's going to be working with hybrid games that is actually quite easily understood from the name of the project, hybrid games. They are willing to connect standard cards, so the paper cards that we're using with digital devices like smartphones, tablets, or readers. And they are facing right now a conceptual and technical issue that they will love Pascal to face. And so he's going to do this, and he's going to create a social game that will really references the challenge of our world, what we are facing nowadays, like could be climate change, migrations, etc. So subjects that are really important and real and not always funny, but it's a real game, let's say, and in a way it's going to be also a pleasant one. So we'll see how a social game can become something else than Monopoly. So let's figure this out.
Yeah, let's look forward. Sci-fi Miners from Joao Martinho Moura. He's a researcher and a media artist. His interests lie in digital art, intelligent interfaces, digital music, and competition and aesthetics. He's working together with the CritCat theory-driven H2020 project. This project tackles several important aspects of emerging nanotechnologies. So Sci-Fi Miners. Miners is the miners of the future, the artistic exploration of how, with the help of scientific advances in nanotechnology and artificial intelligence, critical catalyst materials like complex material, uranium, or will be replaced by their synthetic equivalents with Earth-abundant materials.
Muted. Muted by Christophe Monchalin and Content for All. So Christophe Monchalin is a digital artist and a motion designer that is really exploring mainly human feelings and behaviors. This is why it's really interesting to be linked to the Content for All project, because they are looking at how to translate spoken language, TV, automatically into a sign interpret language and presented via a three-day representation of a human sign interpreter. So this avatar, let's say, would be used and muted. It would be muted would be a virtual reality experience where you poetically be traveling through childhood and sign language. So it's really into sign language and human experience.
Light Matters Project. Stéphane Perrault is a visual artist coming from the performance and the multimedia scene.
Come on.
Thank you for being here. Congratulations. So he presented a project together with the HOT tech project. HOT will create revolutionary technologies based on the interaction of light with the motion of tiny objects. So the Light Matters project is a reflection on lights and matter. Matters. The title itself plays with the two meanings regarding the project itself that play back and forth with the idea of scale, time, and space. So it's a complex tech project. It's an ambitious project, so we really look forward to your residency, Stéphane. Okay.
Printier City, it's by The New Row. The New Row was created by Panos Sakas, he's there. So he's a design and the New Row is a design and research studio that is working on closing material cycle and strengthening local production. The P-Twist, Plastic Twist project aim at designing an open platform that will plastic reuse practices and really boosting citizen awareness about this really huge challenge. And so it's a great union between the Neuro and Petwist to create Print Your City. The idea of Print Your City is really to implicate and urban dwellers and to really make them transform their plastic waste into raw materials, and then these raw materials will be used to create furniture or things that will be used in the city. And this will be made through 3D printing materials. So it's a good way for people to know that the plastic waste can be reused and just let them know about this huge challenge that we should all really be careful of.
Yep. Congratulations.
Thank you for being there.
And I think this is the last one.
Yes,
already?
Yes.
Do you have another one? No?
Oh, yes, I've got one.
Oh, you still have one. Sorry.
You've got one, I've got one.
Okay. Yeah. There is two. Immersive minimalism. Theresa Schubert is a PhD in media arts. She exceeds traditional boundaries of the visual arts by including new technologies and life sciences. The Immersify tech project is brings cutting-edge tools for the next generation of immersive media. So, immersive minimalism is a series of custom-developed studies established on theories of perception that aim at redefining method of immersions. Immersion, an immersive environment called vibrant matter of micro landscapes with real UHD video footage in combination with digital generative graphics depicting non-human life.
And then the 70th, Beyond Absolute, it's by Reiko Yamada and Luca. So Luca project stands for laser and ultrasound co-analyzer for thyroid nodules. So it's an health project. The idea of this project is to develop an innovative technology for thyroid cancer screening that will help having better diagnosis and having better results for this diagnosis of this cancer. And Reiko Yamada is a composer, a sound artist, that is really working, will be working on ultrasounds and create this project, Beyond Absolute. So it will be a two-step residency. First, it will be the creation of a personalized acousmatic soundscapes based on the data generated by the Luca diagnosis device. And then this soundscape will be transformed into an interactive audio-visual installation. So that's the two steps of Reiko Yamada residencies. And I think that's it.
I think this is the time to applaud all these brilliant people that are in the room. And those who are looking at us on the streaming, congratulations. So as soon as Louise and me get off stage, we will release the information on the net. You will have actually all the information, much more information and links to the project if you want to know more about the residencies and the proposal on the starts.eu website. You can also follow the residencies through the blog and, of course, the whole activity of the STARTS community and the various initiatives with social network, Twitter, Facebook, and so on. We are happy because we made it in half an hour.
That's perfect.
And we're very proud of hosting so brilliant people, and congratulations again, and let's now work together to make a brilliant future.
And let's thank all the participants in this call.
Yes.
So we had really nice proposals, and we took a long time to examine everything. So thanks to everyone. It's a pleasure to read your artistic proposal and your tech project. Thank you very much.
Thank you.